Will the sun become a black hole? The simple answer, no. But the reason we know this, and the key to understanding why we don't need to be too worried about being sucked into oblivion, lies in a value called the Chandrasekhar Limit. At the center of our sun, there are billions of densely packed particles undergoing nuclear fusion. This is a process where smaller atoms merge to form heavier ones. At the core, under pressure and heat, hydrogen atoms are converting into helium and releasing energy which we experience as light. Over time, all these hydrogen atoms will get used up and the fusion will slow down, reducing the amount of energy released and cooling the star. The outer shell expands and becomes red, a red giant star. In the core of this star, the helium undergoes a less stable fusion, forming heavier and heavier elements until it consists of carbon. Now this is where it becomes interesting. Heavier stars would shed mass through a supernova, a massive space explosion, and then, through a series of processes, become either a neutron star or a black hole. But most stars, our sun included, become white dwarfs. The carbon core collapses and the outer layer is expelled, forming a white, dense celestial body. With no fusion, there is no energy source. The gravitational pressure is immense. Most white dwarfs have been compressed so much that the atoms no longer exist individually, but as positive ions surrounded by electrons. With so much gravitational force, it's a miracle that they haven't collapsed in on themselves. This miracle is explained with quantum mechanics and something called electron degeneracy pressure. At the subatomic level, no two electrons can exist at the same energy level. When the atoms are squeezed together by gravity, their electron orbits overlap. So electrons are forced to occupy higher and higher energy levels, creating a pressure against the gravitational force and preventing the star from collapsing. This electron degeneracy pressure can only work to a certain extent, until the Chandrasekhar limit. This is the calculated mass beyond which the electron degeneracy pressure would no longer be able to counter the gravitational force, and a white dwarf would collapse. It is equal to 1.4 solar masses, or 1.4 times the mass of our sun. Beyond 1.4 solar masses, this white dwarf would explode in a supernova, with the potential of turning into a black hole or a neutron star. Our sun, however, is well below this limit, and when it does grow old and die, it will become an ordinary white dwarf that slowly loses its energy. Not a spectacular explosion, maybe, but still pretty cool.